If a series has nothing but positive terms, we know how to deal with it. We can use the integral test on it, we can use a comparison test on it, we can use a limit comparison test on it. If the terms alternate between positive and negative, then we have some tools for dealing with it. But if a series has a bunch of positive terms and a bunch of negative terms without any special pattern about positive or negative, then you wonder what to do. And the trick is to look at the absolute values. The absolute values of the terms, well, by definition, they're all positive. And if the sum of the absolute values converges, then we say that the original sequence converges absolutely. Absolutely, in this case, doesn't mean positively sure 100%. It means absolute value. Now, the big deal about absolute convergence is that if it converges absolutely, then it converges. So, for instance, the reason for that is you look at just the positive part of the numbers. If you look at an plus the absolute value of an, well, if an is negative, then that adds up to zero. If an is positive, you get twice the absolute value. And so an plus the absolute value is somewhere between zero and twice the absolute value. Actually, it's one or the other of those, but it's somewhere in between. And from that, we say, suppose that the sum of the absolute values converges. Well then, the sum of twice the absolute values have to converge, because that's just multiplying by 2. But then, the sum of an plus the absolute values converge by the comparison test. If you're smaller than a series that converges, then and you're a positive series, then you have to converge. And then an plus the absolute value minus the absolute value has to converge because this part converges, that's a convergent series, and this is a convergent series, and the difference of two convergent series is a convergent series. And of course, that's just an itself. So if it converges absolutely, it converges. Now, I gave you a proof, but you might still be wondering, yeah, but why does it work again? And the idea is that if it converges absolutely, then what you're adding up is only a finite amount of stuff. The positive terms only add up to a finite amount of stuff. This is twice all the positive terms, and that only adds up to a finite number. And likewise, the negative terms only add up to a bunch of a finite amount of stuff. So you take a finite amount of positive stuff, you subtract off a finite amount of negative stuff, and you get a total that makes sense. So that isn't a rigorous proof. That is. This isn't. But it kind of explains what's going on. So, for example, let's look at a sequence 1 + 4 - 1 + 1/4 - 1/9 + 1/16 + 1/25 - 1/36. This looks like our 1 over n squared series, except that some of the terms are negative. I've made every third term negative. So you got a positive, a positive, a negative. It's not an alternating series. We don't know how to deal with it as an alternating series. All we know is that each term is plus or minus 1 over n squared. Well, that means that the absolute value of an is 1 over n squared, and the sum of the absolute values converges. That's because it's a p series with p equals 2. It converges by the integral test. Well, that means that our original sum converged. It doesn't tell us what number this converges to, but it does tell us this sum converges. Another example was our harmonic series, our alternating harmonic series. In this case, an was plus or minus 1 over n. The sum of the absolute values was a sum of 1 over n, and that diverged. So this is an example of a series that converges. It converges because of the alternating series test, but it does not converge absolutely. We have a name for series that converge, but not absolutely. They're said to converge conditionally. We'll have a lot more to say about series that converge conditionally in the next video.